So this is our chapter 2. Polynomials. So we will start with very basic, that is definition of polynomials. So algebraic expression, हमें पता है कि what is algebraic expression. So any terms, any expression like x square plus 2x plus 3. Okay, so any terms or any expression containing variables. So these are called variables, where x is called variables and constants. Okay, so 3, 2, these are called constant. Okay, so any expression containing variables and constant is called algebraic expression. And polynomials are basically some special type of algebraic expressions. Okay, so polynomials are also algebraic expressions. So polynomials होने के लिए क्या condition है वो हम देखेंगे और हम कैसे हम polynomials को define कर सकते हैं. So polynomials are basically an algebraic expression. In the form of we can write like this, a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on. Okay, so what I mean by this a0, a1, a2, so see where a0, a1, a2 are any constant. A0, A1, A2 are constants. Okay, and x is a variable, and this power is 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the powers of x. So the condition for any algebraic expression to be polynomial is that the power of x should be a positive integer. Okay, so this is the condition, that the power of x can't be a negative integer. Okay, it should be integer, it can't be any fraction. Okay, so it should be integer and it should be positive also. So this is the condition. If in any expression this condition is satisfied, that the power of x is positive and integer, then we can call that algebraic expression as polynomial. Like we can take some examples here. So let's pick some algebraic expressions like x square plus 3x plus 4, then 2 by 3, x plus 5, then 1 by x, then root x plus 6, then x raised to power 2 by 3 plus 8x plus 1. Okay, so these are few algebraic expressions. All of these are algebraic expressions, as you can see, all containing variables as well as constants. Okay, so all are algebraic expression. Now we just have to decide, just hold on a minute. Yeah, Catherine, am I audible to you? Catherine, am I audible to you? Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so okay, let me summarize then. We have just started the polynomials here. Okay, so this your second chapter of NCERT books. So we started with the definition of polynomial. The definition of polynomial is that any algebraic expression. So polynomials are basically algebraic expressions. Okay, so it is an algebraic expressions in the form of this a 0 plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square and so on, and where a 0, a 1 and a 2, these are any constant. So it can be 1, 2, 3, 4 or any fractions, any constant. Okay, and these are variables. We already know what is variable. So x, x square, these are variables. The condition for any algebraic expression to be a polynomial is that the power of x should be a positive integer. Okay, so the power of x, that is here 1 is the power of x, here 2, so it can't be a fraction as well as can't be negative. Okay, so it should be an integer and a positive integer. Okay, so let's I just wrote down here few algebraic expression. Now we are going to decide it, that which one is a polynomial and which is not polynomial. So let's start with the first one. So the first one, if we see, so it is an algebraic expression. Okay, and talking about polynomials, so you can see the power of x is 2 here. Okay, the power of x is 1 here. So all the power of x is positive as well as integer. So we can say this is a polynomial. Okay, now coming to this, so here we have one fraction, but that is not the power of x. Okay, so this is a constant, so it can be anything, it doesn't matter. We just have to see the power of x. So here the power of x is 1. Okay, so it is again a polynomial. Now in this case, if we see, we have 1 by x. So in this case, if we want to find the power of x, then we can write it like this, is equal to x raised to power minus 1. Okay, so power of x is now negative integer, so this is not a polynomial. Now again, talking about this, then power of x is root, and root means it is 1 by 2. Okay, so 1 by 2 can be written as 1, root can be written as x raised to power 1 by 2. So again, we have the power of x is a fraction. Okay, so again, this is not polynomial. Okay, now again, if we see the power of x is 1 here, that is fine. But in this case, the power of x is 2 by 3. So again, we have a fraction as the power of x. So again, this will not be a polynomial. So these were some examples. So now we can decide that which algebraic expression is polynomial and which is not. Okay, so now next we have to see the degree of polynomial. Okay, so degree of polynomial is the highest power of x in any polynomial. Okay, so to decide the degree of a polynomial, the condition first is it should be polynomial. Then we have to see that what is the highest power of x here, there. So let's suppose we have a polynomial x cube plus x square plus 2. So in this case, we have two power of x, one is 2, another is 3, but the highest power is 3 here. So the degree of this polynomial is 3. Okay, So this, in this way, we can decide the degree of any polynomial. So again, if we have any polynomial 5x cube plus 3x. So in this case, again, the degree of polynomial is, what is the degree of polynomial? Please answer in chat box. Three, right? So again, degree of polynomial is 3 here. So in these are the degree of polynomial. Okay, so these are where some basics of polynomials. Now we will see the type of polynomials. So on the basis of this degrees, we have divided the polynomials in different types. Okay, so this on the basis of this degree only, we are going to divide polynomials in different types. So let's start the types of polynomials. Okay, so we have divided, let's start as first is monomials. Monomials. Then second is binomial. I'm explaining all of these here, but first let me write. Then second is binomial. Then third we will have trinomial. And fourth, these are divided, these categories are divided on the basis of number of terms basically. Then next is multinomial. Okay, so mononomials, mono means one. Okay, so the polynomials containing one term will be called mononomials. Then bi means two. So the polynomials containing two terms will called binomials. Similarly, tri means three. So polynomials containing three terms will called trinomials. And any polynomial containing more than three terms will called multinomials. Okay, so if you want to see some examples, so in one term you can write like 4x cube. 4x, okay, so these are monomials. In binomials we should have two terms, so it can be 4x square plus 3 or 2x. Then in trinomials we should have three terms. In three terms we can have 4x square plus 2x plus x plus 3. Okay, so these are trinomials. Then in multinomials we should have four terms at least. So we can write 4x cube plus 3x square plus 2x plus 1. So this is multinomials. So this is this division is done on the basis of number of terms basically. Okay, then there is one more type which is used somewhere, that is zero polynomials. So we should at least know what is zero polynomial. Okay, so any polynomial containing only constant terms, no variables, okay? Only constant terms. Like, you can write 5, okay, 4, there are no variables, so these are called zero polynomials. Okay, or you can say the degree is zero here. Okay, so because we can write here 4x raised to power 0, okay, because x raised to power, we know x raised to power is 1, so anywhere we can write x raised to power 0, that is why we are saying the degree is zero here, and that is why its name is zero polynomial. Okay, then next thing is a standard form of polynomials. Standard forms, in a standard form we just have to write the any polynomials, the terms of any polynomials in descending order of power of x. Okay, so if we have any polynomial like x cube plus x square plus x plus 1, so you can see, okay, so the power of x is descending. Is in descending order. Okay, so that is called the standard form of polynomial. So we just have to write the all terms in the decreasing order of n. Okay, n is n, by n I means the power of x. Okay. So if you write any polynomial like x square plus x cube plus 1, so this is also a polynomial, but this is not in a standard form. Okay, so now we are going to divide again the polynomials on the basis of their degree. So the possibilities of degrees here, that I'm writing this side. And here name of polynomial. So degree can be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3, okay, or it can be 4 also. So we will see up to 4 only. So in case of 0, if degree of any polynomial is 0, it is called constant term, or it is called 0 polynomial. Okay, so we can write here constant polynomial or 0 polynomial. Okay, we can also call it 0 polynomial. In case of 1, we say it a linear polynomial. If degree is 2, we called it quadratic polynomial. If degree is 3, we will call it cubic polynomial. And if degree is 4, it is called biquadratic. Okay, so this division are called are done on the basis of degrees. Okay, so if degree is 0, we are calling it constant. If degree is 1, it is called linear. If degree is 2, we are calling it quadratic. In case of 3, it is called cubic, and in case of 4, it is called biquadratic. Okay, so this division is done on the basis of degree. And that division was done on the basis of number of terms available in any polynomial. Okay, so now we will see some examples of all polynomials. So suppose we have, I'm writing some polynomials here. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to decide out of these algebraic expression which are polynomial, okay, and which are not polynomial, and if it is a polynomial, what is its degree? Okay, so let's start with the first one. So is it polynomial, and if it is a polynomial, what is its degree? Please use chat box now. Use chat box to answer, or you can unmute yourself also, but there's please make sure there should be no noise from background. It is a polynomial with degree 2, right? Okay, so this is a polynomial with degree 2. Check the second one. Is a polynomial degree 2, okay, right? Polynomial and degree 2. Both of you can unmute yourself and answer directly. Okay, so I'm just going to ask which we have who have to answer this. So Charvi, what is your answer? So it already, she already answered, this is not a polynomial. Okay, so not a polynomial.
Yes sir.
Then yeah, Kathleen, is it polynomial or not, fourth one?
No sir. No sir.
No polynomial, not polynomial. What about the fifth one, Charvi?
So, yes.
Yeah, and what is degree here?
50.
50, okay. Okay, so that's it. Let's move ahead now. Now again, I'm writing few polynomials, and we are going to divide these polynomials in different categories on the basis of this linear, quadratic, and cubic. Okay, so let me write here first. So we are going to divide all these polynomials in three categories. First is linear, then quadratic, and then cubic. So linear, I'm already writing here. Linear is fourth one. That is 1 plus x. And fifth one, that is 3t. Now, Catherine, please answer what, which are quadratic here? Kaun se quadratic hai, please answer.
First one. Second one
is quadratic.
Sixth one.
So you are saying first one, second one?
No, not second, only first and sixth one.
Fifth and one and six.
And third one also.
And third one also. All right, Charvi, cubic.
So cubic is second one and seventh.
Okay, done. Okay, so I think we are clear about all these categories and the degree of polynomials. Okay, and what is which algebraic expression are polynomial and which are not. So let me see your NCERT book now. I think just give me a minute. Okay, so this is your first exercise, which is based on this, which we have already done. So fifth question we have already completed right now. Okay, so let's and I think first one is also done. So let's complete the second and third one also, second, third and fourth also. So second one says that write the coefficient of x square in each of the following. So I think, is it clear to everyone which is coefficient? What is coefficient? Okay, so please answer the which, what is the coefficient of x square in the first one? Catherine, what is the coefficient of x square in the first one? Can you explain the coefficient? So coefficient is basically multiple of any variable. Okay, what is the constant term? It can be constant of variable also sometimes. Okay, so generally when we say coefficient, we talk about the constant terms. So it is just a multiplication, the constant which is getting to multiplied by x square. Okay, so you can see here in the first question, the constant that is getting to that is getting multiplied by x square is 1 here. So in the first question, the coefficient of x square is 1. Okay. Similarly, in the second question, what is the coefficient in the second question, Charvi?
So minus 1.
Minus 1, yeah. Okay. Because minus 1 is getting multiplied with x square. So the coefficient is minus 1 here. Okay, Charvi, sorry, Catherine, what will be the coefficient in the third part?
Sir, I didn't get it.
You didn't get it?
No, sir.
Okay, great. Okay. So by coefficient, I think these are basics actually, and that's why I thought I should leave with it. So coefficient is basically the constant. We should call the constant number the constant terms. Okay, with sign. Getting multiplied to variables in any term. Okay, This is a concept of algebraic expression basically. So if we have some algebraic expression like 5x square plus 3 by 2x minus 2x is cube, okay, then we have second one is 2 root x plus 3x cube minus 2x. So we have these two examples here. So it's saying the coefficient, the constant terms in this case, if we talk about the first one here, the coefficient of x square is 5, then coefficient of x is 3 by 2 and coefficient of x cube is minus 2. Okay, similarly in the second part, the coefficient of root x is plus 2 and the coefficient of x cube is plus 3 and the coefficient of x is minus 2. Okay, so Catherine, now you got it. Okay, so now let's get back to NCERT. So yeah, now can you answer what is the coefficient of x square in third part, the third question?
Two.
Not 2, it is pi by 2, right?
Yeah.
2 is degree here. If you are seeing this 2, then this 2 is degree and it is pi by 2.
Yeah, pi by 2.
Yeah. Okay, and what is the coefficient of x square in the last one, fourth one?
Minus 1.
No, as you can see, there is no term x square. It is talking about x square only, okay, right? And we have no x square here, so the coefficient is 0 here.
Okay.
Okay. Mm. So if that term is not available, it means the coefficient is 0 there.
Okay.
Okay, but if you talk about the coefficient of x, then the coefficient of x is root 2 here. Okay, the coefficient of x in first term is 1. And what is the coefficient of x cube in the second question?
Minus 1.
x cube.
2?
The coefficient of x cube, x raised to power 3.
Cool.
In the second one. Is it not visible? Question is not visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Now? I'm talking about the coefficient of x cube. It is written 2 minus x square plus x cube. Okay? So if no number is written here, it means 1 is there, okay?
Mm.
It means 1 is getting multiplied to x cube. Mm. In that case, the coefficient of x cube is 1.
Mm.
Okay, so I'm just, let's take more example. Like if you talk about the first one, is this question, this first part, then the coefficient of x square is here. What is the coefficient of x square?
4.
Coefficient of x?
Minus 3.
Yes, and let's talk about this third one. Then the coefficient of t is, what is the coefficient of t?
3.
Not t, I'm talking about t. See, t is where? It is root, yeah. T, not t. Yeah, and coefficient
t, 3.
No, I'm talking about t.
0.
Not 2, root 2 here. You see, t is here.
Okay.
Okay. Then the coefficient of, let's leave that one. Coefficient of x we have already done, okay. Okay, so we just have to see the number, that constant term which is getting multiplied, okay, the constant part getting multiplied in any terms. Okay, so let's see, we have, it is not a big thing, okay, so you will get it by doing this few exercises, okay. Let's move to the give one example. Is it clear now or you need more examples, Catherine?
It's clear, sir.
It's clear. Okay, so now it's saying us that give one example each of binomial of degree 35 and a monomial of a degree 100. So give me a example of a binomial of degree 35. Yeah, Charvi, you give the answer to this one. What is the example of a binomial with degree 35? So what are binomials?
With two terms.
Yeah, so what give me a polynomial with two terms and its degree should be 35.
So it can be anything.
Yeah, but tell me now. Tell the answer. We just have to write that, right?
Yes, sir.
So what should be given? Just say it, any term, any polynomial.
So 7x plus x raised to power 35.
7x plus x raised to power 35. Okay, right. So, but we should write x raised to power 35 first, right? In a standard form. Okay,
7x later.
Okay, great, correct. Okay, then come to that thing. You give this example of this polynomial of degree 100.
X raised to 100,
right? Okay. Then the fourth one is write the degree of each of the following polynomials. So we just have to write the degree here. So Catherine, you give the answer first and second one. What is the degree in the first one?
The first five.
Degree.
Three and two.
Degree is three, right? In first and in second.
Second question or second term?
Second part. Second question.
Two. Two,
right, correct. Okay, then Charvi, what is the degree in the third one?
So I think one.
One, okay, and degree in fourth one?
One.
Not one, it is zero. Okay, if there is a only constant term. Okay, so I already discussed it.
Okay, sir.
It means there is no variable terms. It means that in that case, degree is zero.
Zero. Okay, sir.
Okay, so this one, right? If there is no no variable terms, it means there is x raised to power zero. It means its degree is zero.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so we have completed all the concept up to 2.1. Now just zero sub. Okay. Now let's start with the value of polynomial. So when we say value of polynomials, it means value of polynomials means value of any polynomial at any given value of x. Okay. Like let's take a simple example. Like if we have a polynomial x plus 3, so we know that x is a variable, so x can take any value. Okay, because it is a variable, so we can give any value to x. So generally a polynomial is written like this: px is equal to x plus 3. Okay, or if we have a polynomial in variable y, then we can write like this: y square plus 4. If variable is t, then we can use t here. Okay, like t cube plus 4. Okay, so this is just a representation that it says that we are talking about a polynomial. So px, py, pt. Okay, so this is just a representation. So now we are talking about the value of polynomial. So value, if we are saying value of polynomial of this, a value of polynomial in this polynomial, then suppose we are talking about at a value of x that is 2. Okay. So it means the value of polynomial at x is equal to 2 will be equal to 2 plus 3. So what we have to do, we just have to put the value of x at the place of x. Okay, so here I just put down the x is equal to 2. So we have, and we will write it like this, p2. Okay, so p2, it means p2 is equal to 5. Now again, p is not necessary to write p only. We can write p, q, r, a, b, c. We can use any alphabet actually. Okay, so p is basically a polynomial representing this one. So let's use, we have suppose three polynomials. One is p, the second one is q, and third one is r. Okay, so I just found the value of p at the value of at x is equal to 2. Similarly, you can find p3. So what will be p3? I am saying the value of polynomials means I am talking about the value of any polynomial at any given value of x. It means we will be given that we find the value of this polynomial at x is equal to 2 or x is equal to 3 or x is equal to 4. So that value will be given to us that you have to find the value of polynomial at x is equal to 4 or at x is equal to 5. And we will be given the polynomial also. So in this case, I'm just taking an example like px is a polynomial. Okay, px is equal to x plus 3. So this is our polynomial, and now just we have to find the value of this polynomial at different value of x. So I just found the value of this polynomial at x is equal to 2. So if we have, if I have to find the value of p2, it means what? It means the value of px at x is equal to 2. So if I have to find the p2, so we just have to put the value of x at place of x. Okay, so I just put down this 2 here. So now I have 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5. Now is it clear? Can you find p3 now? Catherine, can you find P3? How did you get 2? You mean these 2?
Yes, sir.
No, this 2 is random. You can take, it will be either given in the question. Okay, so you just have to find the value of x is equal to 2 or x is equal to 3. This is a random value. Okay, so this will be given to you. Okay, just like I'm giving here that x is equal to 3. Okay, so this value will be given. Okay, so if you have to find the p3, then I will put this 3 at the place of x. So this is 3 plus 3. So it is 6. Okay, so can you try now what will be P10? What will be P10? Correct. Okay, so in this way, we can find the value of this polynomial at any given value of x. Okay, so similarly, suppose we have another two polynomials, that is Q, Y, and R, T. Okay, So if let's find two values, this Q2, what will be Q2 here? Catherine, how you got 5? It is y square plus 4, right? I'm using this one now. Q, I'm talking about Q. I think you put down the value here. Okay, I'm talking about Q now. Yeah, so now if you have to find the value of Q2, we will put 2 at the place of y. Okay, so it will be 2 square plus 4, and it will be 4 plus 4, that is equal to 8, right? So similarly, if you can you find R5, what will be the value of R5? Yes, hai na? So this is 125 plus 4, that is 129. Correct. So what will be the value of then R0? R0 is 4. Okay. Then similarly, you can find Q0. What will be the value of Q0? So Q0 is again 4, right? So I think we got this, right? That what is the value of polynomial. Okay, so in next lecture now we will see the zeros of polynomial. So I think it is enough for today. Okay, so just I will send you some small assignment by tonight or tomorrow morning, okay, on WhatsApp. So just try to complete that assignment before next class based on this concept which we have discussed today only. Okay, so based on this up to value of polynomials. Okay, so try to complete that assignment by before next class. Okay, so I'm ending the class now. Okay, thank you.